Hi everyone, welcome back to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews. As you all know, we have been testing quite a few of the new smartwatch range from AMAZFIT. And what we did notice is that the AMAZFIT GTR 2E as well as the GTS 2E are showing sometimes quite strange results in regards to heart rate, especially during an activity. So what we are doing is we are continuously testing the GTS 2E as well as the GTR 2E to make sure we pick up the time when there is an update to the software to make sure that the heart rate shown on the watch is actually correct. And that's exactly what we have done with the GTR 2E just a couple of days ago. We're also going to be doing a GPS comparison in test in this particular review. So the benchmark for the GPS distance will be done by the Polarbeat app using iPhone 12 GPS receiver. And we're going to compare and test it against the GTR 2E GPS receiver sitting inside the watch. So the GTR 2E does have inbuilt GPS. Previously, the results were quite iffy at best. Now, let's take a look at the numbers as well. If you are new to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews, we talk about the latest tech news. We do brutally honest reviews and share hacks and tricks along the way. So what I did on the weekend is I actually went up into the hills, into the forest for about an hour, and I was walking quickly with different paces all over that forest on the hill and trying to see if the heart rate will be accurate on the GTR 2E. Now the benchmark was a Polar H10 chest strap. So as we know, that is an ECG chest strap, and it is supposed to be one of the most accurate chest straps in the world today. So what we're going to do in this particular test and review is we're going to plot the H10, and then we're going to put the plot of the GTR 2E on top of that, and we're going to match it, compare it, and we're going to share the results with you. On top of the active heart rate test, what we actually did is also check the heart rate during sleep. So the benchmark there will be a medical device which does measure your heart rate every 1 second, and that is the O2 ring, and here it is right here. So you put this onto your finger. We actually have a specific review about this device on the channel, and I'll leave a link just above me right now. So check that out. So this is a medical device which tracks your heart rate with medical grade accuracy. And this actually gave us a heart rate during the night, a resting heart rate of 68 beats per minute. Now, the GTR 2E gave us a heart rate of 67 beats per minute. That's very close. Now, slightly more complications came along with the active heart rate, so let's take a look at that right now. Firstly, let's have a look at the heart rate as registered by the Polar H10 ECG chest strap. So the average heart rate was 134 beats per minute, while the max was 162 beats per minute. So the GTR 2E, using the optical heart rate sensor on the back of the smartwatch, has actually come up with an average heart rate of 121 beats per minute, while the max was 158 beats per minute. If we talk about the max first, that's actually quite an improvement, because if you have seen the previous tests and comparisons, you could see that the max as well as the average would be off by quite a bit. Here we have a max variance, a heart rate max variance of just 2.5%. That is quite a sharp result. In regards to the average variance, yes, here we can see 9.7%, or an understatement of 9.7%. The reason for that is quite obvious. We can see that halfway through the walk, so at approximately the 30 to 35 minute mark, the heart rate has actually stabilized, and I wasn't walking uphill, I was actually going around flat country, flat land, and the heart rate had to drop to about 120 beats per minute. But what the GTR 2E optical heart rate sensor has actually picked up is much lower than that. The heart rate picked up by the GTR 2E was registered at about 100 beats per minute, and we're looking at a continuous variance of about 20 beats per minute for half an hour. We can still see a problem with the calibration of the heart rate. at the lower end of the spectrum, while the peaks are being registered quite well. And we can see that during the first half of the walk, the peaks and the tracing of the optical heart rate sensor is very close to the H10 ECG chest strap. On top of the heart rate test, we actually did a GPS accuracy test as well. And this is another point where we were waiting for an OTA update on the GTR 2E. Because previously, the GPS would be off by miles. And now let's take a look at what was registered by the Polar BTAP using the iPhone 12 GPS receiver. And then, of course, the GPS receiver on the actual GTR 2E smartwatch. I've actually been quite impressed with what the GTR 2E showcases now in regards to GPS. Let's take a look at the numbers. So the Polar Beat app using the iPhone 12 GPS receiver has actually measured 4.94 kilometers covered in the forest. Now the GTR 2E actually comes up with 4.89 kilometers. So if you previously had a look at our tests, we would have huge differences. Now the difference is just 50 meters or just 1%. That's a really sharp result, and that's considering that that was a very leafy area. There's a lot of trees, there's a lot of tree canopies, and there's very little open land, mostly forest, and still the accuracy is very good. So a difference of just 1%. Anyway, thanks for watching this review, test, and comparison. What I can add for myself is that I can see a drastic improvement in the quality of metrics coming up from the GTR 2E. So the GPS is showing us very sharp results. If we talk about resting heart rate, I think it's also on par. In regards to active heart rate, I think that we're still facing slight issues. So where we see actual activity, where the intensity is higher and pushing the higher boundaries of your heart rate, we can see that that tracing by the optical heart rate sensor on the back of the GTR 2E is registering quite well. But when the heart rate does drop to a more stable level, we can still see an underestimation or an under registering by the GTR 2E. But hopefully that will be fixed quite soon as well. Thanks for watching this review and test. If you did find it helpful, then please drop us a like. And if you want to see more of the same, then you know what to do. Please click the red subscribe button below the video, and I'll see you in the next one.